Hey Pixels! In this week's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to design your very own interactive app prototype in Adobe XD. The design for this app is very nice and modern. Be sure to visit my blog, xopixel.com, to read the article for this tutorial. Now, let's get started. In Adobe XD, click the Artboard tool and select Android Mobile from the predefined artboard sizes in the right-hand panel. You should have a total of 2 artboards on your workspace. Now, we're going to make the gradient background in Adobe Illustrator by creating an artboard that's 360 by 640 pixels and using the gradient tool. The 2 colors used to make the linear gradient is a blue and a green color. The details will be in the article on my blog. Once the gradient has been made, copy and paste it onto the first artboard in Adobe XD. First, let's give this app a name. Place the logo 122 pixels down from the top of the canvas. Then, using the rectangle tool, draw a rectangle that's 283 by 47 pixels. There should be a 35 pixel space between the logo and the first rectangle. Then, round the corners of the rectangle by 27 pixels. Duplicate the rectangle shape 2 more times to create a total of 3, and then place them below one another, leaving a 21 pixel space. Fill the first 2 rectangles with white, and then set their opacity to 20%. The last rectangle will have no fill and a white border that's 2 pixels. Now, we're going to add some icons. First, we're going to add the hamburger menu icon to the top left corner. Then, we're going to add the mail icon to the left-hand side of the first rectangle, and then the person icon in the second rectangle. Finally, we're going to add 3 social media icons, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, at the bottom. We're also going to add some text for all the text boxes and the button. Now, we're going to start working on the second artboard. First, we're going to copy the design on the first artboard and then paste it onto the second artboard. We're going to move the whole design so that only part of it is showing. Be sure to delete the hamburger icon and then add an X icon in its place. We're also going to delete the sign in text and the last 2 social media icons. To create the slide out menu, draw a rectangle that's 222 pixels by 640 pixels on the left hand side of the artboard. The color fill for this rectangle is black and its opacity will be set to 60%. Then we're going to slide the gradient background over to fit the entire artboard. This is so that when we add the prototype effect, it will look like the menu is sliding in and out. Then we're just going to use the text tool to write out some links that we're going to use on the menu. To make the app design interactive, we're going to go into the prototype mode. Then, we're going to select the hamburger menu icon and drag the wire to connect it to the second artboard with the following settings: slide right, ease out, and then we're going to set its duration to 2 seconds. For the second artboard, we're going to select the X icon and drag the wire to the first artboard with the following settings: slide left, ease out, and then set the duration to 2 seconds. Finally, to test out the app prototype, click the play icon at the top, and then click the menu icons. It should look like you're opening and closing the menu. This looks really cool. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe to XOPixel for more great design videos just like this one. I'll see you in next week's video.